Welcome to the Autodesk Face Robot Legacy video series. These are the original videos that Jeff Wilson recorded using Face Robot version 1.5, long before it was integrated into Autodesk Softimage. In these videos, Jeff, who is one of the original designers of Face Robot, focuses on tuning and sculpting the different regions of the face. The workflow shown in these videos is still pretty much the same as it is now, but you might notice a few differences in the interface. For a more up-to-date version of the complete Face Robot workflow, you can check out the 11-part Face Robot series on this channel, which uses the current implementation of Face Robot within Softimage. We hope you enjoy this blast from the past as Jeff displays his mastery of facial animation with Face Robot. In this video, Jeff goes through the first three stages of Face Robot, assembling the parts of the face and picking landmark spots on the face that identify its proportions.
Okay, we're going to start this with a realistic female head that was modeled by Z Jones at Blur Studio. And I'm going to take this from just raw mesh all the way through final solving, and obviously will be edited down to the important parts, but this is going to be an actual case of solving a head. So to get started, what we're going to have is just the parts Face Robot requires, which is head mesh and eyeballs and upper and lower teeth. There's a tongue in here that I'll hide for now. Rig that up later. So to start with, you just want to check a few things on your mesh. And let me unhide the head here. Main thing being that your head mesh needs to be solid except for the hole in the base of the neck. There are eye sockets, as you can see here, and a mouth cavity. And if you don't have those pieces modeled in, there are tools in Face Robot that will let you model those parametrically after the fact. Although it's always best to kind of do it the way you want up front. So everything on this is one solid mesh. And there's QC tools built in that will tell you if these things don't meet the requirements. Otherwise, that's about it. You just want to have nice topology and, you know, control where your wrinkles are and where your flow lines are. The eyeballs are just standard objects. You want to make sure that the centers are accurate on those, because that will be the point of rotation later, so you want those to be centered correctly, and just have your teeth aligned the right spot. Okay, and all you do to start is define which type of face it is, if it's symmetrical or asymmetrical. Z's models are always really nicely symmetrized, so you can take advantage of that here. And this will just allow Face Robot to do a lot of the work for you during some of the picking and modeling stages later. Okay, and then it tells you to pick objects. And then it just walks you through what to pick. So the face mesh first, then pick the eye, upper teeth, lower teeth, and then it creates these entries for you. And you can always change these if you want to go back and repick the head mesh. You can select that and repick it if you pick the wrong thing. Hit assemble when you're done with that, and it will bring up this panel and tell you if there's anything wrong. It'll show up in red, like if you have extra holes in the mesh. If there's operators on the stack, it's going to collapse. It will tell you. It's going to freeze the modeling stack. And then when it's happy, it gives you the ready to scan line. So after you hit scan, this launches the picking session, so you can find landmarks and define certain areas of the face that it uses for proportions. So we'll just go through this phase, and as you notice, as I click off-center, it will actually center things in the middle for you, so you don't have to be dead accurate there. And if you pick on the left side, it'll automatically pick the right side for you, since we told it was a symmetrical head. And another thing to notice is middle clicking will reverse the process, rewind it, and you can pick it again. And if at any point you click out, right click to end that session, just resume, puts you back where you were. And if you make a bad pick there, you can actually go in outside of the session and delete those objects, and it will ask you to pick them again. And if you accidentally delete one of the objects when you're in a symmetrical head, it will rebuild that for you as you resume the picking session. So it's pretty bulletproof on this phase. You can go through it pretty fast without worrying about making an unrecoverable mistake. So it's just asking you to pick all these little landmarks, and it gives you really good imagery here to tell you what it's looking for. And I'll just go through these and pick what it's asking. It's not super critical at this stage. You want to be careful, but it doesn't have to be, you know, it's not a live or die situation at this point. You can tweak some of this stuff out later. The only thing to be a little careful about is the mouth corner. You want that to be pretty accurate so that you don't get a bad solve there. And you want to just pick just outside of the corner a bit, just to give it a little room to work. And then you pick around the Adam's apple, and neck tendons. And ears. So that's a picked head. And I usually will save at this point in case I want to go back to this stage and readjust some of these picking points. So we'll just save this as picked.